What's up everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we'll be talking about the upcoming transit of South Node Ketu through the sign of Scorpio. Especially in today's video, we'll be mainly emphasizing on what will happen if South Node Ketu is transiting over your natal planets. Now, what does that mean? If you have any planet in the sign of Scorpio, so for the next 18 months, Ketu will transit over that planet and it will create a major impact. Right now, Ketu is transiting from the sign of Sagittarius. On 19th September 2020, Ketu will move into the sign of Scorpio and it will stay there till 17th March 2022. Now, before we proceed and talk about Ketu's impact over each and every planet, let's briefly understand what does it mean to have Ketu in Scorpio? What kind of results will Ketu give in this sign? Few days ago, I posted this video on Instagram and captioned it as Ketu is approaching towards Scorpio, get ready. And many people asked me, what does that video mean? Well, Ketu is right now in the sign of Sagittarius. It is moving through the Mula Nakshatra. Mula is all about the Barhanam Shakti. Barhanam literally means pulling and tearing apart of things. So right now, indeed, Ketu in Mula is tearing away everything. It has destroyed everything. And this destruction is the key to new growth. Finding your potential, moving towards new growth and a new foundation. That's how Ketu is working in Mula. Now, since the destruction through the Mula Nakshatra has just happened, now it's time to move towards the growth. So just look at these plants. They just explode or burst, which helps them to release their seeds, and this dispersion to faraway areas results in growth. So Ketu in Scorpio is all set to convert your potential energy into kinetic energy. What does that mean? Well, all of that talent, potential and energy which was hidden within you will now come out. It's time to get in action and show the world who you truly are. So this period will be all about transformation and introspection. See, Ketu loves the sign of Scorpio. It co-rules this sign. Why? Because Scorpio represents the 8th house of a horoscope. 8th house is the doorway between the death and a new transformation. Okay, it's moving towards the 9th house, which means a new cycle. In the same way, Scorpio is all about transformation and rebirth. So Ketu over here will definitely give positive results and a life-changing transformation. Throughout this transit, Ketu will move across the nakshatras of Jyeshtha, Anuradha and last pada of Vishakha. We'll talk about this in detail in the next video, where we will also talk about the impact of this transit on all 12 ascendants. But for now, if Ketu is transiting over your natal planet in Scorpio, then the major theme of this transit is to understand yourself, dive deeper and identify your true power, strength and identity as well. See, Ketu is in Mula, so it's all about the Barhanam Shakti, tearing and pulling apart and start with a new cycle. Now with Ketu moving towards Jyeshtha, Jyeshtha is all about the Arohan Shakti, the power to ascend and climb higher in life. So yes, now with your newly found talent and potential, you're all set to move higher in life. But the most important theme of this transit, leave your emotional baggage and fears way apart from you. Because Ketu is in Scorpio and Scorpio is about fear and emotional baggage. So this new cycle is all about leaving your fears, mental trauma and unhappiness just far away from you. Now, before we proceed further and talk about the impact of Ketu on each and every planet, there are a few things which you need to consider. Number one, what all houses in your horoscope are ruled by planet Mars? Number 2, where does your natal Mars is placed? Number 3, in which axis this Rahu Ketu transit is happening? Number 4, what is your present Mahadasha and Antardasha? So you have to consider all of these points to understand how this transit will work for you. Remember, we are talking about the transit of Ketu over the natal planets, and Ketu is all about ending and new cycles. So please don't expect it to bring material results and luxuries in your life. It's all about soul level changes. So let's begin. With Ketu transiting over the Lagna in Scorpio, you would observe a massive transformation in your personality and thinking as well. Throughout this period, you will be guided by your intuitions, because Ketu transiting over the Lagna will sharpen your intuition and insight as well. Lagna is everything. It's your personality, individuality and identity. Therefore, Ketu here is going to initiate a new cycle in terms of personality, growth and success. The very first step in this transformation will be detachment and withdrawal, because Ketu is coming to this place after 18 years. So for all of these years, your soul was undergoing a major lesson, and now you might feel saturated and tired. Therefore, you might isolate yourself from the world. No, it doesn't mean that you will hide yourself in a dungeon. Isolation means focus on your energies, focus on yourself first. You will reject and withdraw from the expectations of the society, because it's the time to follow your own ideology. Ketu over your Lagna may make you overly emotional and sentimental in nature. Especially, you might think a lot about what has happened in the last few years. It could be possible that your ability to stay focused and dedicated may get affected. That's why Ketu is causing detachment, because it wants you to take off all the emotional baggage and trauma. It's time to reset, reorganize and reassess your goals. In this transit, Ketu might bring sudden changes which will act as a catalyst for your personality development and growth. You might suddenly develop a deep interest in occult astrology, ancient science, history and even spirituality. A deep research and learning will keep you busy during this time. At first, you won't be much concerned about how you look, but gradually in this transit, you will work towards transforming your appearance, especially experimenting with your hairstyle. With Ketu transiting over the natal sun in Scorpio, at this time you will try to get rid from some kind of authority in your life. It could be your workplace, home, family or a partnership. Anywhere, there will be an intense desire to get out of control and authority of others. Ketu is here to wash all the ego and understand the true meaning of your self-identity. Because it wants to tell you that ego doesn't mean to think about your desires and importance, but it means to focus on the voice of your soul, a voice which will show you the right path always. So throughout this time, you will focus towards understanding yourself, what is the right path for you. Remember, all of this is happening in the sign of Scorpio, and that's why this transit is going to sharpen your intuition and vision as well. Therefore, this is the best time to introspect and plan for your future journey, because there will be outstanding clarity which will help you in understanding what's best for you. You might take a break to focus on your true qualities and how to use them. Some difficulties while dealing with father or a father-like figure may happen, or even there could be health issues with respect to an important male figure in your life. Intense inclination towards spirituality, astrology and occult is possible. Also, you might come across divine beings, maybe through your visions,
meditation, and even in dreams, a lot depends upon in which house this transit is happening. If you are expecting some kind of inheritance, then you have to wait for it. Avoid getting into a new partnership in terms of work, business, and even marriage. Overall, during this time, you will intensely look for a medium to make the best use of your skills and potential. With Ketu transiting over the natal moon in Scorpio, this time could be quite intense in terms of emotions. Moon in Scorpio is considered to be debilitated because here Moon is in an environment of fear and darkness. Now, transiting Ketu over the natal moon is all set to make you detach from others on an emotional level. No, there is nothing negative about it. This transit is happening for a reason. Maybe in the last few years you have invested your emotions and mind on something which was unsuccessful. It could be your work or a partnership, and this particular aspect of your life have hindered your growth. There was just destruction. Therefore, Ketu is here to isolate, detach, and cut ties from such emotional bondings which are blocking your growth. Therefore, detachment will lead to a new cycle as you will prepare to move forward with great determination and focus. At this time, you have to focus on your intuition. What does your higher self wants to follow? You will incline towards the spiritual path. This is the time to reassess which aspect of your life requires your emotional energy. Sudden changes of mood, a sense of fear may bother you. Connection with the mother or a mother-like figure may get affected. Take care of your mental health as it will greatly impact your physical health, fitness, and stamina as well. If Ketu is transiting over your natal Mars in Scorpio, this would be the time of a massive shift and transformation, more in terms of physical energy. The best part of this transit is it's all happening in the sign of Scorpio because Mars and Ketu both rule over this sign. During this transit, you may feel that till now you were directing your energies into such things which don't serve you. You never gained much even after working so hard on these issues. So it's the time to reassess and think about what really matters in life, what all things truly require your precious energy, and what all things don't deserve your efforts at all. It would be a difficult task for you to focus on just one thing, as Ketu will scatter the energies of Mars. Which means at one point of time, you might think about doing many things altogether. Therefore, you won't be able to use your energies in a focused manner. So because of this, you will take a pause to re-energize and bring all your energy at one point. The gift of this transit would be a sharp insight, the ability to understand things in a great way. Taking decisions within an impulse or a sudden manner should be completely avoided. Also, avoid getting into any arguments or conflicts, especially with the siblings. Health needs great care. Precaution and safety is required while traveling or dealing with inflammable objects. Health issues related to fever, infection, or abdomen may happen. With Ketu transiting over the natal Mercury in Scorpio, a lot is going to happen in terms of thoughts and communication. First of all, you are going to change the way of your speech, or it could be that you would cut down the interaction with others. Sometimes when our mind is intensely processing a thought or an important issue, we generally don't like to talk or intervened by others. It's the silence which helps us to focus. Ketu over natal Mercury, that too in Scorpio, will bring a lot of nervous energy, doubt and confusion regarding some important aspects of life. That's why you would opt for detachment from friends and your surroundings. In fact, it's a good thing because Ketu wants a major transformation, and it all starts from transforming your own thought process. Suddenly, out of nowhere, your mind will be occupied by past memories of your life and even previous life as well. And these memories will show you the right direction, because Mercury is the divine messenger. So these thoughts coming to you all are a part of divine plan. This transit may lead to misunderstanding with near and the dear ones. So be very careful how you communicate and convey your thoughts to others, or you may feel misunderstood by others. A great shift towards spirituality and higher power is indicated. A good time to write about your ideas, thoughts and beliefs, as it will help in the long run. Confusion while taking important decisions is the main theme, so take your time in this process. Health issues related to skin and nervous system may happen. If you are into a business, then you have to be extremely vigilant while working or dealing with the business partner. With Ketu transiting over the natal Jupiter in Scorpio, it marks a new beginning in terms of knowledge, wisdom, thinking and belief system. Jupiter is the Karaka of wellness, spirituality, education, knowledge and higher thinking. So at this time, you will say goodbye to the old patterns of thinking and ideology, because these old patterns of thinking will not serve you anymore. Your point of view about life will transform. Also, you will develop sudden interest in understanding and learning about different cultures and religious systems of the world. Overall, this transit promises a new learning. Health will require great care. One of the major themes of this transit would be working on self-faith, as you are going to detach yourself from the belief system of other people. You don't want to understand or give in your energy on what others are expecting from you or what kind of beliefs they have about you. You will just focus on your values, ideas and beliefs. Jupiter is also the Karaka of children and husband in a woman's chart. So something significant related to that may happen, especially for women, whether you are married or committed in a romantic relationship. This could be a time of ending and a new beginning in terms of partnership. There is a new cycle promised, and a lot depends on in which house natal Jupiter is placed. Traveling to spiritual places or a pilgrimage is also possible, and this will bring a life-changing transformation. Be very careful about how, when and where you will spend your money. Most importantly, do not demoralize or degrade yourself, because what you think is what you would attract at this time. With Ketu transiting over the natal Venus, the need to find an intense and strong bond of love will go higher. Yes, Ketu causes detachment, and Venus is the Karaka of love, luxury, romance, marriage and relationships. Then why Ketu's transit is increasing the desire to be loved? Does this mean that the forthcoming transit will bring detachment from love? Yes, it will happen too. You will seek such a bond of love which is way above any formalities, personal gains, terms and conditions. You seek a strong spiritual bond where there is unconditional love, and there will be definitely ending and a new beginning in terms of romantic relationship or partnership. You may cut ties and withdraw from such people who are dependent on you, where the foundation of the relationship is based on personal gains, greed and temptation. It's not a good time to be secretly in love with someone, because it may create a lot of unhappiness and dissatisfaction. Venus is the Karaka of wife in a man's chart, so definitely some significant changes in the married life would be seen. In terms of business, be careful while starting with a new partnership. More than any money or luxury, you will look out for such pleasures in life which are way above the material wealth. If you are into a profession related to creativity or healing, this would be a good time. Also, you may discover a new talent at this time, because remember, Ketu is in Scorpio and it will open up the past life seeds. So definitely you will discover a talent maybe from your past life. And yes, at this time, spend your money wisely. Suddenly you might focus towards simple living and there won't be any desire to look fancy and posh. With Ketu transiting over the natal Saturn in Scorpio, this is the time for a new cycle in terms of career. Saturn is an indicator of profession, success, achievements, responsibilities and duties. So certainly, having the transiting Ketu over the natal Saturn, that too in the intense and transformative sign of Scorpio, it completely indicates a massive transformation in profession. And yes, it would be more of a positive transformation. But initially, you will think that everything is changing around you. There will be a lot of struggle. But yes, these changes are taking you towards a positive change. Getting rid of the old patterns of working, responsibilities and duties is indicated, because you know that the old way of working or the current situation isn't rewarding enough. Despite of making so much efforts, if things are not working according to you, then it's time to cut the ties and detach from such duties which are no longer required, or maybe these duties are making you feel burdened. You may feel guilty and trapped in this process of detachment, but trust the timing, as you are all set for a more prosperous and stronger foundation. During this transit, avoid making sudden decisions with respect to family and profession as well. On a soul level, if you feel dissatisfied from your present journey, then it's time to surrender and give a pause, as this would help in rearranging your life. You have to reassess your goals and plan for a better foundation. A feeling of anxiety or fear may persist, as you may feel resistant to changes happening around you. Having faith on yourself and doing meditation would provide great determination. Also, renewal of professional skills is indicated, which will help a lot in future. The transit of Ketu over the natal Rahu in Scorpio would bring a life-changing experience, because here the past life account meets the present life account. During this time, there will be changes happening all around you, and these changes will push you to focus within, reassess your priorities, goals and thinking process as well. Depending upon in which house this transit is going to happen, you will experience such challenges which would further bring massive transformation. Breaking old patterns, routines and habits, all of this will happen over here, and it will be all because you have to incline higher. You may withdraw from materialistic pleasures and passions. On the other hand, you will learn to beat your fears and insecurities. All of these changes will take you much closer to the voice of your soul. Just the way you clean and declutter your house, in the same way, this transit of Ketu over your natal Rahu is all set to declutter your life. All of this detoxification will happen with respect to the house where natal Rahu is placed. It's not a good time to focus on what others are thinking about you. Just focus on what you really find meaningful. Spirituality and working towards your wellness will be a major theme of this transit. If transiting Ketu is over the natal Ketu in Scorpio, this marks the beginning of a new cycle in life. This transit is happening after 18 years when Rahu and Ketu will be at the same place, which means your true natal position in the chart. Therefore, this time period is very significant as it brings completion and end of a chapter in your life. Well, what kind of chapter? This depends upon in which house this transit is happening. Since the sign of Scorpio is all about regeneration, renewal and transformation, definitely you will undergo soul level transformation and your perspective and ideology towards life will change. More interest in occult, astrology and even spirituality will happen. This transit will bring an important lesson where you have to learn to let go the unresolved issues of your life, especially such pending issues which are related to emotional trauma, difficult memories, abuse or anything which made you feel humiliated. The theme of this transit is to heal the old wounds and move ahead towards your destiny. Your mind will work towards new strategies on how to initiate your new journey and invite more fulfillment for your soul. Overall, this time will be like a rebirth and there will be a new project and a new journey. But it's very important to leave all the past trash behind you. Detach yourself from the past fears and traumas as this is the only way to enjoy a better tomorrow.
So guys, that's all for today's video. Make sure you subscribe to this channel. Take care. Goodbye.